So slash in R7 will do. So it will just go back and make a refresh and come front. So this is how info, yeah? Z info underscore Durga. Right click on here. Now do insert characteristics has info parameter. In other words, it's an info area. Okay, that's we call doing target system. So next step is create target system. So I'll give my customer ID, because customer is the primary key where you can change. So Z cust underscore du. So when you expand this cust underscore du, we get two options, attribute and text. So this is my SAB BW here, cust ID. When you expand cust ID, we got Z attribute. Why test is not came? Maybe test will also come. Maybe save somewhere, I think. Okay. So next step is right click on here. We need to perform change and do maybe master address not coming here. Okay, I'll go here, attribute. Under attribute tab, we need to enter that attribute field, which is ZH. Which is Z address. Which is Z phone number. Then simply activate. So once it's done, next step we need to create. So we done this flow diagram, this one and this one. Now create a transformation. So next step is create transformation. So how to create transformation? Under modeling, go to info order, right click on this attributive field, create transformation. That's all. And my data sources, so we need to choose us, we are getting data from the data source, so choose the data source. So we need to choose this option called data source, and we need to also enter the data source name, which is we have ZDS underscore text. So we give a name here is ZDS underscore ATTR. So we need to enter this name. So choose data source ZDS underscore ATTR, and the file is Z file underscore dur. So once click enter, maybe ds underscore att. Let me check what the data source name we entered previously. So go to data source. So it is ZDS underscore ATTR. We also do from here also, just create transformation. But we have to enter info object by upper cases. Z cust underscore. So it takes some time to activate this transformation. So once we create a transformation, the next step is we need to create a data source. So now we are creating a transformation between target system, which is of info object, this one, to transformation of data source. So it will do just field to field mapping. So it perform field to field mapping. So we done that creation of source system, which is a file system. Then we done the creation of data source. The name is zds_attr, and the same file system is called zfile_durga. And we done the creation of info object, which is our target system, under info provider. So once it's done, we'll go with the data source options. So SAP login pad. So this is my SAP login pad. Log on to BI with a credential. And I told you earlier the T code for the BW is RS7. So enter RS7. Then this is our data source, so right click on here, we need to create a transformation. So right click here. So just right click on data source and it will be created. Create transformation. So we are loading upper part, it's called info object. The name is z cust underscore du, then enter. Z customs for du. Now it will create a transformation. So it is called field to field mapping. It's called. So we just activate this transformation. So once it's done, so next step is we need to create the. So the entire flow is ready. Now we need to go to the diagram. Loading of data. Let me check you the flow diagram. This is my info area. Z customer right click here. See display data flow diagram, choose upwards and downwards, enter. Okay, is that so? This is my target. Under main target, I'm loading master attribute. This is my transformation, which is green color, success, data source, and show system. Right? So, my diagram is correct. Next step, we need to load IP and DDP for loading data. So, before loading, I need to create a show system file which of flat file system CSV. For that, I'll just create a source system file in the Excel file and save it as comma delimiter. CSV means comma delimiter. So we need to generate a CSV file. We can also use a text file, but we need to save the text file as CSV with a comma separator. So we need to use a field, same custom ID, age, then address, then phone number. So we need to use the same structure of a source system, because we in the data source also we maintain the same structure. So start all programs, Microsoft Excel sheet. Now just first fill is the custom ID. Second fill is age, address, phone number. So the custom ID, the custom ID 2 23 24, Hyderabad, Pune, Mumbai, Kerala, Goa, alert. I'll take so in certain places. So let me take some sample records of 10 or 5 records, and we need to do IP. So those records we need to load to IP. Then we need to perform DTP data transfer process. So that data will be loaded to a target system called data source. So I'll write here Punjab. Enough certain fields here. So let me take these two records as sample one. One of the 10 records, and let me just take this as age and some certain sample records of address. Let me take the phone number which we took for 9, so let me use as 9 digit number. So we'll take the sample records of 10 records of CSV file, and we'll use the same file to do the activities, okay? I'll take the same records. With some records here, let me save this file as a CSV. On desktop we'll name it as ATTR. So it should be a CSV comma delimited file. And the file should be closed before loading. It's my file here, ATTR file. Then let me open the file once again. Okay, so these are sample records of file. Okay, so we are loading this data, and always a file should be closed before loading. If file is not closed, it throws an error. So the file should be closed. So we need to get its file structure, custom ID, age, address and phone number, which we have certain 10 records of customer information. We have age, address and phone number. So always the file should be closed before loading, and it should maintain a CSV comma delimiter file. So once it's done, so close our file. Because the file is already ready, now we just load data, that's all. File should be closed. Now first step is we need to create IP, so go with the here data source, right click on your data source, create IP info package. I'll mention here load data. And under here extraction tab, we need to browse our file. It's of CSV file. So browse my data here. Now it just loads the data. Once the file is selected, we need to start loading the data. So it helps you out to perform any activities on this data loading process. Now start your file from here, browse your file. So we see the file in the desktop, so that's all attr file. So browse that attr file from the desktop. So it's my desktop. So browse the file which is CSV from desktop. The file name is attr. The file name is attr. It's of type CSV. I'll just type A, it will appear. This is my file. And file has heading right, so ignore first row. It's a CSV, so choose CSV. CS means comma, so here enter comma, then simply save the changes. For loading, go for schedule and start loading data immediately. Now it's loading data from a local file system. Now it's done. In order to the records in the PSA, so right click on data source. Now we can check the data in the PSA. So here the PSA is nothing but persistent staging area. It is used to check the quality of data for each and every record. It means that it will just check the if the record has any commas, semicolons, some underscore, something else, that record will be avoided here. So PSA is a template table which we have slash BIC slash PSA table name. So PSA has right click here and go for the manage in order to see the PSA data. So it's green color success. Then this is a PSA symbol, just like a round circle symbol. Then once you got this, we got 10 records and enter. Let me check the records in the system. Okay, so I have 1 to 10 records. These are records in my PSA. Okay, now I got the PSA data. Then let me load this same data into a DD, that's in the targets, the Cofa info powder, and create DDP. Right click here, create DDP, network data transfer process. Enter. Now we need to activate this DDP. You can see when you execute here, it's inactive now because the record is inactive. For activate, so for this we need to do activation. So for activate this data source, activate this DDP, then execute. So the record will load it from the data source to target symbol. Then simply OK. Now execute here. So once you execute, now it's the loading is started from source system. So it's done. Can see the status, we got 10 records is loaded. So let me check the same records in the source, in the target. This is my target right click here, and this option called display data. Simple. So field port to selection. Set all characteristics, execute button, again execute. Okay, these are the records we got. So we have address and age, phone number and customer IDs. So this is how we can get this records system at any level. Let's clear it. This is how we can load the data. Let me check the flow diagram also once again. This is my flow diagram in which we have a target, we do have transformation, data source, cust ID, and we do have a flat file system. So these are how that we can load data into different formats. So this shows the data loading process of master attribute data loading into a BW system. So here we use the flow diagram first, and we follow the same thing from the bottom to up approach, which we have cust ID, age, address, we took phone number, all this stuff has the attribute fields, and we created info objects, info area, and all these things will take place here. So we create data source, assign info objects. Okay, so we need to follow certain steps based on this requirement. So this is how we can load the sample data loading process from this system. Okay. So next, so in this series of videos we are learning of complete BW of modeling structures. In the next video, in the coming next video, we'll see how we can load the master data text object. So we load the master data attribute, we done. Let's go with the text object in the next video. So I'm Raju, I'm just signing off now, but we meet on next video with a different concept called master data text data loading process. So thanks guys, thanks for watching this video. We'll meet, we will just meet on next video.